Assalamualaikum students of grade 6 Cambridge and matriculation stream. This is Ms. Meher Munir. Alhamdulillah, we have completed 4 contents of our English language and today we are starting our content number 5, that is verbs, the present tense. According to your grammar trees, tenses are divided in 4 kinds: present tense, past tense, future tense and the perfect tense. They have separated the perfect tense. So we will learn according to grammar trees, and in this video we will learn the present tense and its 2 kinds, that are simple present and present continuous. What are tenses? Tense demonstrates the time, or it shows the time of an action in a sentence, usually performed by the subject of the sentence. The actions are called verbs. As we all know that verbs are known as action words. Verbs change according to tenses and other issues. These 3 pictures are showing the past tense, the present tense and the future tense. What we are doing right now is our present. What we had done in before our present is the past, and what we will do after the present time will be our future time. What is simple present tense and what is present continuous tense? The simple present tense. The simple present tense is the base form of a verb with s or es added for the third person singular, he, she, it and other singular nouns. When the subject is singular, we will add s or es in the base form of verb. Examples are there: he sings very well. He is the third person and is the singular one, so he sings very well. We added s in the base form of sing. Example number 2: Rija looks tired today. Again, Rija is the singular noun and it is the third person, so I added s with the word look, so it became looks. Rija looks tired today. How the negative form is created? The negative is formed with do, does plus not plus the base form of the verb. She doesn't sleep till late in the morning. We added does according to the subject, and of course when it is a negative form we have to add not and plus the base form of the verb. She doesn't sleep till late in the morning. I don't like conflicts. Now here I is the plural subject, so I added do, which is the plural form. I do not like conflicts. The interrogative is formed with do, does plus subject plus the base form of the verb. The interrogative form is similar to the same we learned interrogative sentences in our chapter forming questions. We learned how to make questions. So here they are telling how a question is formed of a simple present tense. The interrogative is formed with do, does. We have to start the question with a helping verb and then the subject, and then the third thing will be the base form of the verb. Do you cook on weekends? Do is the helping verb, you is the subject and cook is the base form. Do you cook on weekends? Does he know what he is writing? Does he know what he is writing? Does is the helping verb, he is the subject and know is the base form of the verb. Let's understand what are the conditions or what are the situations when we have to use simple present tense. To show a habitual action, custom, routine or a habit. She travels to school by bus. This is her routine, that she has to travel by bus to the school. So we used simple present tense. She travels to school by bus. This is showing her routine, her daily routine. To express a fact that is true at the time of speaking, there is no breeze. This sentence, there is no breeze, is showing a fact which is happening when I'm speaking to you. There is no breeze, so I used simple present tense. To show a future event which is already arranged, the World Cup begins tomorrow. This is a future event, as the word tomorrow is showing that it is going to happen in future, but it is already arranged, so I used simple present tense. The present continuous tense. The present continuous tense refers to an action that is going on, because it's the word, of course, continuous. It is the continuing tense that is going on at the time of speaking. When I'm speaking to you, the action must be going on or must be continuing. We don't know when the action started or when it will be over. Its form is M is R plus the present participle of the main verb. He is eating. He is eating. We used the helping verb is according to the subject he. Of course, we cannot use M or R with the he, with the subject he. So I used is. He is eating. Eating is the present participle of the main verb, eating. It's the present participle. So it is a showing, it's showing that he is eating, and it's a continuous action. That is why I used present continuous tense. I don't know when he started eating or when he will be done with that, with her, with his eating. The negative is formed with M is R plus not plus present participle of the main verb. Same as the sentence, but only we have to add not in it. He isn't eating. He isn't eating. He is not eating. The interrogative is formed by interchanging the positions of the subject and the auxiliary. Is he eating? We just interchanged the positions of the subject and the helping verb. Is he eating? So it became a question. Uses of present continuous tense. These are the situations when we have to use present continuous tense. When we are describing an action that is going on at the time of speaking, I am drinking coffee. To describe an action that is not necessarily taking place at the time of speaking, but by which has relevance to the present. They are building a fly over here. It's not necessary that the thing is happening right in front of me, but it is happening in the overall sense. They are building a fly over here. To show an action that is almost certain to take place in the near future. We are going on a vacation next week. This is the thing that is going to happen in the next near future, that we are going on a vacation. So I used present continuous tense. I hope we all learned simple present tense and the present continuous tense. There will be Google meetings with your class, so we will learn again further which is remaining and which is given in the book also. So try to practice the exercises given in your books to make yourself clear about the present simple present tense and the present continuous tense. Thank you so much.